For engineering services general studies video lectures, visit www.isgeneralstudies.com. For mechanical engineering video lectures and question and answers discussion, visit www.gatemech.com.
We have seen the moving average methods till now, and the main disadvantage of these three methods, moving average, weighted moving average and exponential smoothing method, is that they cannot capture the trend or seasonality and the components of the data. Okay, so if some of the time series data is showing some trend over time periods, so it's increasing with a annual increase or monthly increase, it's showing some trend, then we use this trend projection method or least square method to capture the trend in the data. So for that we use an expression which is similar to a linear regression method. Basically, we are trying to fit a line of the data based on the time period. So if you plot the data on the graph which is showing some trend, it will be like this. So it's showing up. So we are trying to fit this data using a curve. In this case, assuming a linear, we are fitting a linear equation. This is a linear equation. We are fitting a line on the data so that we find out the sales of next period using this line. So basically, we are trying to find a relation between, or we are trying to find a relation between the time and the sales. So we are trying to fit a curve with the given data points and find the forecast for the next period. So this we call it as a trend line. Okay, so as I mentioned, this is Y is nothing but the sales of the product, and A and B are constants which you need to calculate by using least square methods, and then T is the time period, so be it years or months, whatever it is. So, and B represents, if it is say years, if it is years, B represents the annual increase in the sales. If T is in years, so every year we are multiplying this B to the T, that means year 1 it will be 1, year 2 it will be 2 into B. So this represents the annual increase in the sales, that is the slope of this line, whereas A is a constant which represents the intercept of this line. This is A, and slope of this line will be the B. Okay, and using least square method we calculate these values of A and B. So the expression for them is, so A and B can be found by using these equations. So this is basically T, and A into sigma T plus B into sigma T square. So once we find values of A and B, we use this expression to calculate the forecast for the sales for next period T. So the basic assumption in trend projection method is that the time series data which we are considering shows a trend, and assumption is that it continues to be there in the for the future as well. Okay, so we, in this case, we are taking linear trend only, and the trend can be exponential, that will be fitted using another exponential expression. So this is an example for linear trend represented by this linear equation. Suppose if we have the data with one or more components, like say trend and seasonality combined in the data, so how do we forecast for the future in that case? So let us take an example, the same example I'm talking about. So the sales of air conditioners. So the sales of air conditioners will have, so in a year, based on the seasons, it will be more in summer and normal in other seasons. And when you see over years, so and only the summer season, so it will show a trend. So from year basically 2015 to 2017. Okay, so here it is showing a seasonality component. So in summer it is showing a peak, here it is showing over years for multiple summers there is a trend, it's showing a upward trend from summer 2015 to 2016 and 2016 to 2017. So the same data consists, but the same sales data consists of both these components, the seasonality as well as the trend, right? So to capture these both the components, apart from this we can also see the randomness as well as cyclic component as well, but considering only these two components, so decomposition method is used to capture these components from the data. So how the decomposition method works is it considers the sales data, basically the historical data, so it will find the trend and seasonality from the data. They separately calculates trend and seasonality components, so finds the estimates for each of these components, for each of these trend and seasonality, okay, and then combine these estimates to arrive at forecast. So first it considers the sales data, the historical sales data, and it captures the trend and seasonality separately from the historical data, and estimates the future trend that is possible as well as the seasonality index. So basically the trend index and seasonality index it will capture, and those two components it will combine to arrive at the future forecast. Okay, so there are two models which we already discussed which uses these components separately, that is one is additive model, another is multiplicative model. In additive model, the forecast is arrived by combining these components, by adding these components, that is trend component plus seasonal component, and other two components are also possible, that is cyclic component plus random component. Okay, this is how the estimates are added in this case. So in case of multiplicative model, the forecast is multiplication of the trend component into seasonal component into cyclic component into the random component. So this is a more, when we have all the four components, this is a more complicated model to arrive at, to calculate it for the data. So we didn't see any questions on this till now, but theoretically this is the concept, and you can expect a theory question based on this method. So understand this method, how it calculates and uses these models to arrive at the final forecast.
For engineering services, general studies video lectures, visit www.iesgeneralstudies.com. For mechanical engineering video lectures and question and answer discussion, visit www.getnet.com.